Hey everyone, Michelle here with Evolution Productions. I got a new switcher, so I just wanted to show it to you real quick. It's the Avmatrix HVS0402U. Four HDMI inputs, two HDMI outputs, and it also outputs as a webcam. So you can output directly to your computer, which will see it as a webcam, so you can easily stream. So let's look at it. Here it is, just a little guy. Here's my hand. It's not that big, but it is mighty. It's about, it's this thick. Whoops, this thick. I'll show you in a minute. It's got the four inputs, so top is the program bus, and the bottom is the preview bus. We have some audio controls. We have Luma, Chroma controls here. Picture in picture logo controls here. These are for your transitions. You can also do still or freeze frames, which is great, and you can do that on both buses. And then a pattern overlay, so that might be a logo or it might be whatever you set it. An image could be whatever you set it to, and that's all customizable. Let's take a look at the back real quick here. Oh, here's a little shaky. Sorry, you can see the width of it slightly. As two 3.5 millimeter inputs there, along with four HDMI inputs, a Multiview out, a program out, and there's the USB out, so you can go to your computer. Networked, it does have some software that comes with this one, and you could also use tally lights if you like. Although that's a separate adapter that you would have to get. So, okay, here it is. Let me show you the multi-view. This is what it looks like on the multi-view out of the box. So you have your program and preview on top, and then you have your four inputs to the left. And to the right, this little box here is this kind of shows you at a glance what your audio is up to. Also what stills you might have stored. So I have my dog Brandy Alexander Hamilton in there. It's color bars and a little logo. So yeah, so let's just go on and I'll show you a little bit here. I'd like to get into the menu, so I'm going to push this little button here. It's just a little knob, a little twisty knob. And when I push that, I will go back over here. It took me to here, so I'm going to exit out so you can see. That's what it used to look like. I pushed the knob once, it goes into here. click it again, and get a little deeper into the transitions. Here you can pick your transition, and you can show your color of your. I don't know why you'd want that pink. I wouldn't. I'd probably keep it black. But point is, you can change it if you like that your dip color. So we'll exit out of that. Transition speeds. You have two different speeds for that. Here's your Luma key. You can choose your sources. Mine are set to my computer, which is on HDMI 2. I'm not going to go through all of this, but I will show you what it is. Here's where you set your chroma. Here's where you would key out your color. Here, that little box, so I could say fetch it. I can move my box to wherever I want it, and then it'll fetch that color for me. So we have a good key out on that. Again, more things I'm not going to go into here, but here's your picture in picture. You can change this color for your border, whatever you'd like it to be. You can change your width of your border here, whatever you'd like it to be. Auto, I think, goes to 16. 15 goes to 15. Here's two picture in pictures. You can pick your source and turn it on or off and size it here. And for both of them. Picture outside a picture. There's not a button for this, so you have to come into here to activate the picture outside a picture, and that is just two side by side picture in picture side by side at 50%. So it's just all done for you, and you can lay that over the top of another layer, so that's nice. Downstream key, it just fades it in instead of cuts it. The Luma, it just fades it in. Your logo, can turn that on or off. Here we have your audio. You can enable your master on off, and each one of your inputs has you can enable it, disable it, audio follows video or not, and you can delay each one if you need to. You can also delay the master if you need to. And the mic's coming in, so lots of options for that. You can also change your input mode from line to mic if you need. You can change your what you're listening to. You don't have to listen to the master. You can listen to any of them separately. You can change your layout from horizontal to vertical on your Multiview, but I like it this way, so we'll leave it. And here's your audio meters. You can put them on or off in your Multiview, so you don't have to see the bouncing bars, but I certainly like that, so I keep it. This is all Multiview settings. The UMD, that's basically your label. And so you can enable the label or not, and then you can also go in and name it here if you like something different. It's easier unit interface for the program. The Windows program makes it easier to do that. I'll show you that briefly too. Here, the pattern, you can pick what you want. There's a button that says pattern. When you click it, whatever you pick here is what's going to come up. So you have one on preview and you can have a separate one on program bus. Here's where you would capture your image. Those are the ones I have in there, and you just come over here and say, yes, I want another one, and upload it. Oh, actually, I don't think I have. Sorry, I don't have a USB attached, so I won't be able to show you that, but that's how I would do it. Or you could use one of these as a source. So I could actually, what do I have into? Let's see. I could bring in that. Now I have that as an image. So that's nice. It was fast. It's a fast way to do it. We can change the colors. Actually, this is just color, so what's one of the options when you choose your pattern? You can choose just a color, so you can add whatever color you like there. Your outputs, you can change. So your multi-view isn't a multi-view out. You can change that. You can make your program whatever you like. I really love this part of this unit. Any of these outputs, you can do whatever you want with them, send them any which way. It's very versatile. Frame rate. So this only does 1080, guys. Your program is 1080, different 1080i or P at different frame rates, but 1080 is the one that you're going to get with this unit. You could change your color sprays, but I don't know why you would. So yeah, fade to black. You can change the speed of that. You can tell it not to mute with your fade, or you can. And then the system settings is the last thing. So there's all of those things. Lots going on with this unit. Okay, so now let's go back to the board, and I think I'm gonna go in here. Okay, so here are the audio portion. You can see master, mic one and two. You can turn off the mics just by doing that. This will actually enable it. Click it once and it's blinking. Now you can turn it off or on. That's the on button. So it's not on. Now it's off. Now it's on. And then you hit the mic again or that button again. If it's not flashing, then that's. You can only change it if it's flashing, right? So, like input HDMI 1, maybe I don't want it to follow video, so I would turn that off, and then I hit the one again, and now it's not going to follow video. So that is that. And there's up and down volume buttons right here. So the audio, it's really pretty simple. Pretty simple laid out. These are your chroma keys here. So let's take this big for a second. Oh, wrong one. There we go. So here I have my chroma key set up for my HDMI 2 input. So if I were to hit this chroma key here, it's going to key over preview. If I hit this one, it says on air. You can't see it's pretty small from there, but it's going to key over program. Okay. If I hit the chroma key and then I take it, it's going to take the image behind it and then take it to air or to program. And then now you can't see because the star's in the way, but the on air button is lit up instead of the chroma button. So I'll take it back and I'll take that off of chroma, right? Same thing with the Luma. I hit the Luma button. You can see it's lit up there. If I hit the on air button, now they're both lit up and they're both on air. If I take that off of air and if I take the cut, it will take it with whatever's underneath it. We'll take that back. We'll take that off. And now downstream key is faded in. See how it fades in? And if I were to take that, let's try to fade it. There we go. That didn't really work, did it? So on air, let's try that. It fades in that way. That should have worked, but it didn't. So that's interesting. Okay. Picture in picture. There it is on same idea. If I push the left side, it shows up in the preview bus. If I push the on air button, it shows up on program. Or I can bring it in on the preview bus and then bring it over by taking the layer underneath it plus the PIP. If I do it from the preview that way. So there's a couple different ways to do that, and then that's same thing with the number two PIP. I could take those both individually to air. So, and those are sizable in the other interface that I was showing you before. The logo is just a little, small little thing. You probably can barely see it. It's a little bug just came up at the lower left of the preview and program windows. I'll take that out. Here we have the mix. Let's see here if you can see that. I don't know if it's close enough. There we go. So these are the transitions. So we have the wipe, which we can adjust in that other menu that I showed you, and dip to whatever color we set. Invert will change the wipe from going left to right to left, right? Or however you want that set up. This button, a multi-view button, the idea is that if you want to set your multi-view to something else, let's say you want to see your HDMI one full screen, and then you hit the multi-view and it goes back to multi-view instead of the HDMI one full screen or whatever you set it. So it's kind of a toggle for your multi-view. That's the idea behind it. I haven't gotten that to work, unfortunately, but I think that is the idea behind it. So that's that part of it. We have a mute button that is mutes everybody, which is awesome. And then and a fade to black. And again, we have a full T-bar. Boy, still having a wipe. And then a cut button. So that is a really quick overview of what this little guy will do. I do want to show you the interface, and I believe it's PC only, but let's look at it. Okay, so here it is, and let me find it here. Okay, so when you get in there, you just hit the scan button, and it will scan. It will find your unit. If you have multiple units, you'd be able to pull that down here and pick the one you want. But you can see it's just preview and program, just like it is on the unit itself. These buttons will switch the input, pattern, or you could do the freeze frame. I'll go over that real quick too when I get back to it. Here are your transitions, your Luma key, your Chroma key, all your PIPs. I wish they had a button for POP. I miss that button. You have to go into the settings to find it, but it's not the end of the world. Mute, fade to black, different speeds for your auto transitions, T-bar even here. Here to the far right are some settings that there's the POP status. I could turn that on here. So that's probably exactly how I'll use that. here, and then you can set these up. Maybe a little easier than going into the menu, although the menu is not hard. You can see these audio settings are here. All the things that we've gone through already are here also. So it's just maybe if you prefer having this kind of a interface. Media library, you could upload from your computer directly, which is great. You don't need the USB to plug into the side to upload it. You can do it from your computer here, so that's very handy. And here you can again change your output for your Multiview program and USB. And here is how you would restore settings and change your time, because it's likely it won't come, with the right time that you need. So let's see, let's go back here for a second. Just wanted to show you the freeze frame. So here, right next to each bus has a pattern and a still button. So here's the pattern button. I have that set to bars, and then I have to click in order to get out of it. You can't just click the pattern button again. You actually have to select a different source. Okay. And for the still, here's the still. Oh, there's Michelle's still. She's stuck. If I push the still again, it does unfreeze me. So let's do that again. I want to do that, and then I'm going to actually cut it, and I'm still frozen. So it holds the still even after a transition, and then I can hit it again, and it did not unfreeze me. It just froze program again. Interesting. So I'd have to reselect. Oh, there I am. Yeah. Okay. So you just have to play with that a little bit. Let's see. Let's take that one to there. And let's see. A pattern on this bus is Brandy Alexander Hamilton. Hi, Brandy. And then the still on this bus is just the same. It will, well, you couldn't tell, but Brandy would be frozen if she were moving. So now, in order to get out of that, I need to select. Let's select that. Sure. Or that. That's good. Okay. All right. Well, that is a quick overview, guys, of this little unit. I think it's comes in at like, oh, what's the price? $549 or something like that. I think it's worth every penny. It's got a lot of things, a lot of bells and whistles. The Blackmagic Mini doesn't have the output capabilities that this does. So I'd be more inclined to get this just because I don't own Blackmagic cameras. If you just need a little switcher, this one really does pack a punch. That's it. If you have questions, let me know. If I don't know the answers, I'll try to find them for you. And if I do know the answers, I'll let you know what those answers are. So, I guess that's it for this one, guys. Thanks a bunch and happy streaming.